Good morning, students. Today I will take Unit 4, RTOS based embedded system design. So these are the topics under Unit 4. The first one, introduction to basic concept of RTOS, then task, process and the threads, then interrupt routines in RTOS, multiprocessing, multitasking, preemptive and non-preemptive scheduling, task communication, shared memory, message passing, inter-process communication, synchronization between process, semaphores, mailbox, pipes, priority invention, then priority inheritance, then comparison of a real-time operating system. Under this, VxWorks microcontroller or operating system 2 with RT Linux. So this is the introduction of an operating system. So let's see what is an operating system. So now an operating system is the system software that manages computer hardware and software resources as well as providing common functions to computer programs. Operating systems can be found on a wide range of computer based devices from cellular phones and video game consoles to web servers and supercomputers. So, operating system is an interface between a computer user and computer hardware. An operating system is a software which performs all the basic tasks like file management, memory management, process management, handling input and output, and controlling peripheral devices such as disk drivers, printers, etc. Then, what is the need of an operating system? Operating system is most important software that runs on the computer. It manages the computer's memory and processes as well as it's a software and hardware. Okay, it allows you to communicate with the computer even if you don't know the understand its language. Okay, then how the operating system was introduced. So it is a set of special programs that run on a computer system that allows it to work properly. It performs a basic task such as recognizing input from the keyboard, keeping track of files and directories on the disk, sending output to the display screen, and controlling peripheral devices. Then, what are the functions of an operating system? So, three main functions. The first one, manage the computer resources such as central processing unit, memory, device drivers, disk drives and printers. Then second one, establish a user interface, and third one, execute and provide services for application software. So these are the three main functions of an operating system. Then the next slide shows the kernel services for an operating system. Okay, so one more important thing is, in computer system, it includes a basic set of programs called operating system. The most important program in the set is called as a kernel. The kernel is the core of the operating system and is responsible for managing the system resources and communication among the hardware and other system service. It is loaded into RAM when the system boots and contains many critical procedures that are needed for the system to operate. A kernel is the functional layer of an operating system. It's a functions at a basic level communicating with the hardware and managing resources such as RAM and CPU. The kernel performs a system and checks and recognize components such as a processor, GPU and memory. It also checks for any connected peripheral devices. So there are these are the main parts which are available in kernel services of an operating system: process management, primary memory management, file system management, IO device management, secondary storage management, protection system, and interrupt handler. So these are the main parts which are available in the kernel services of an operating system. Okay, the next slide shows the real-time operating system, that is called as RTOS. So real-time operating system, commonly known as RTOS, is a software component that rapidly switches between tasks, giving the impression that multiple programs are being executed at the same time on a single processor core. Okay, so real-time operating system are used in an environment where a large number of events are mostly external to the computer system must be accepted and processed in a short time or within a certain deadline. Such applications are industrial control, telephone switching equipment, flight control, and real-time simulations. Okay, so three major functions. The first one is a real-time kernel, second one hot real-time, and third one is a soft real-time. Let's see the first one, that is a real-time kernel. So real-time kernel is known as a RTOS kernel. In addition to the traditional operating system kernel, the real-time kernel is a highly specialized and provides only the minimum necessary of services required to operate user program or task. The fundamental functions of the real-time kernel are as follows. The first one is a task or process management, second one task or process scheduling, third one task or process synchronization, fourth one error or exception handling, fifth one memory management, and sixth one interrupt handling, and last one is the time management. Let's see the first one, task or process management. Set up the memory space for the task, load the task code into the memory space, allocate the system resources, create a task control block, that is a TCB, for the task, and terminates the task process. So a task control board, TCB, is used to store information related to a task. So the TCB contains a task ID, state, type, priority, context point, memory point, system resource point, and overall pointers, that is a task pointers. Then the TCB settings and the implementation are determined by the kernel. The TCB parameters vary across different kernels based on the task management implementation. The TCB of a task is used by the task management service in the following ways. The first one, that is a create a TCB for a task on creating a task. Then delete or remove the TCB of a task when the task is deleted or terminated. Then read the TCB to get the state of a task. Then update the TCB with updated parameters on need basis. Then modify the TCB to change the priority of the task dynamically. Okay, so this is about a task or process management. Then second process, that is a task or process scheduling. Okay, share the CPU amongst multiple tasks or processes, that is called as a task or process scheduling. Task scheduling is handled by a kernel application named scheduler. A scheduler is nothing but an algorithm implementation that provides efficient and optimal task scheduling in order to offer deterministic behavior. Then third one, that is a task or a process synchronization. So it deals with the synchronizing the concurrent access of a resource which is shared across multiple tasks and the communication between various tasks. So that is called as a task or process synchronization. Then fourth one, error or exception handling. So here in this function, it deals with the register and handling errors occurred during insufficient memory, timeout, deadlock, then deadline missing, then error divide by zero, unknown instruction execution for that period, this type of error occurs, or error handling, or exception handling. So one of the examples of errors or exception are errors or exception are happen, that is at the kernel level service or at the task level. Okay, for example, kernel level service at deadlock, this is the best example for a kernel level exception. Then timeout is an example for a task level exception. So hot shot timer is a mechanism for handling the timeout task. Certain task may involve the waiting of external events from devices. So these task will wait infinitely when the external device is no responding, and the task will generate a hang up behavior. So in order to avoid these types of situation, a proper timeout mechanism should be implemented. A watchdog is normally used in that situation. So watchdog timer will be loaded with the maximum expected wait time for the event, and if the event is not triggered within this wait time, the same is informed to the task and the task is timed out. So if the event happens before the timeout, the watchdog timer is resettled. This is about error or exception handling. Then next one, memory management, that is a fifth function, memory management. In general, memory allocation time increases with the size of memory block that needs to be allocated, and the current state of RTOS employs a block based memory allocation technique rather to the traditional dynamic memory allocation techniques used by the allocational memory block. So the RTOS kernel allocates blocks of fixed size dynamic memory to task on a need to know basis. A free buffer queue is used to store the blocks. Memory security is optional in some commercial, that is RTOS kernels, and when an unauthorized memory access occurs, the kernel enters a failed safe mode. Suppose if the device supports secondary memory storage, means a few RTOS kernel implement the virtual memory principle for memory allocation. A block of fixed memory is often allocated for task on a need to know basis if block based memory allocation, and it is treated as a unit. As a result, a memory fragmentation would not be a problem. Memory allocation can be implemented as a constant function, resulting in a memory allocation taking a fixed period of time. Then RTOS kernel deterministic action are unaffected by this. So garbage collection is often avoided with the block memory principle. With a restricted option of a memory chunk size and a suboptimal memory utilization, block memory allocation achievements deterministic behavior. So this is about memory management. The next one is interrupt handling. So deals with the handling of various types of interrupts. Interrupt provide a real-time behavior to system. Then interrupt inform the processor that an external device or associated task required immediate attention of the CPU. So interrupts can be either synchronous or asynchronous. Interrupts which occur in synchronous with the currently executing task is known as a synchronous interrupt. Usually the software interrupt fall under this synchronous interrupt category. Divide by zero, memory segmentation error, etc. are the examples of a synchronous interrupts. The interrupt handler for a synchronous interrupt runs in the same sense as the interrupting operation. Asynchronous interrupts are interrupts that occur at some stage during the execution of any task that are not in line with the task that is currently being executed. Asynchronous interrupts include interrupt created by external device connected to the processor or controller, time overflow interrupt, serial data transmission interrupt, and so on. In case of asynchronous interrupt, the interrupt handler is typically written as a separate task that runs in a separate context. The majority of RTOs kernel use the nested interrupt architecture. So interrupt nesting allows the interrupt of an interrupt service routine, that is ISR, servicing an interrupt by a high priority interrupt. Then last one is a time management. So accurate time control is required for all application to include accurate time references. A high resolution time real-time clock RTC hardware timer provides the kernel with the time reference. The hardware timer is set to interrupt the processor or control at a predetermined rate. This timer interruption is known as a timer tick. The kernel uses the timer tick as the timing reference. The internal timer tick can differ depending on the hardware timer. The timer tick usually varies the microsecond range. The timer parameter for the task are expected as the multiple of the timer tick. Then the system time is updated based on the timer tick. The timer tick interrupt is handled by the timer interrupt handle of the kernel. The timer tick interrupt can utilize for implementing the following action. That is save the current context, increment the system time register by 1, then after that update the timer implemented in kernel, then activate the periodic task which are in the idle state, then invoke the scheduler and schedule the task again based on the scheduling algorithm, then delete all the terminated task and their associated structure, that is a TCB. And then load the context for the first task in the ready queue. Due to the rescheduling, the ready task might be changed to a new one from the task which was preempted by the timer interrupt task. Then second one, a hard real-time operating system. So it is defined as a system in which a task has a deadline. A task has to finish by the deadline. If a result is delayed, a huge loss may happen. Hard real-time is a system whose operation is incorrect, whose result is not produced according to time constraint. For example, air traffic control, then medical system. So these are the examples of a hard real-time. Then third one, soft real-time. So this operating system provides some relaxation in time limit. So soft real-time system is a system whose operation is degraded if results are not produced according to the specified time requirement. For example, multimedia system, digital audio system, etc. So the difference between hard real-time and soft real-time is, in hard real time, the size of the data is small or medium, whereas in soft real time system, the size of the data is large. In hard real time system, the response time is in millisecond, whereas a soft real time system, the response time are higher. Then hard real time, the peak load performance should be predictable, whereas a soft real time system, peak load can be tolerated. Hard real-time system, safety is a critical, whereas a soft real-time system, safety is not a critical. Then a hard real-time system is a very restrictive, whereas a soft real-time is less restrictive. Then in case of error, in a hard real-time system, the computation is rolled back. Whereas in soft real-time system, computation is rolled back to previously established a checkpoint. In case of a soft, that is a hard real-time, satellite launch, railway signaling system are the best examples of hard real-time. whereas the DVD players, the telephone switches, the electronic games are the examples of a soft real time. Then the next topic, task, process and threads. Let's see the first definition, that is a task. The task refers to the something that needs to be done, that is called as a task. So the task can be one assigned by our managers, or one by our professors or teachers, or one related to our personal family needs. So everyone has an order of a priority and a schedule or a timeline executing these tasks. So in the operating system context, a task is defined as the program in execution and the related information maintained by the operating system for program. So task is also known as a job in the operating system context. So a program or part of which in execution is also called a process. The term task, job and process refers to the same entity in operating system context, and the most often they are used interchangeably. Then the second one, that is a process. So process means any programs is in execution. The idea of a process allows task to be executed concurrently, allowing the CPU and other system resources to be used more efficiently. The sharing of the CPU among the process allows the concurrent execution. Process control block controls the operation of any process. So process control block contains information about a processes. For example, process priority, process ID, process state, CPU, then registers, etc. Then the next slide shows the structure of a process. So the idea of the process allows the task to be executed concurrently, so allowing the CPU and other machine resources to be used more efficiently. The sharing of the CPU among the process allows concurrent execution. So a process has properties that are similar to those of a processor, such as a set of registers, a process state, a program count that point to the processor, next executable instruction, and a task that is a stack that contains the processor local variables and code. Then a virtual processor is a process that acquires all of the CPU properties and wait to have them transferred to the physical processor. The process registers and the program counter register are mapped to the CPU physical register when it gets its turn. Then the next slide shows the memory organization of a process. The process memory is divided into three categories. The first one is a stack memory, second one data memory, and third one is a code memory. All temporary data such as a variable specific to operation that is stored in a stack memory. Then all global data for the operation is stored in data memory. Then computer code for the operation is stored in code memory. The next slide shows the process states and state transition representing diagram. It takes more than one step to complete a process from start to finish. So during its transition from the newly formed state to the terminated state, the process passes through a number of states. The first one is a process life cycle, refers to the cycle by which a process processes from being produced to being completed. Okay, that is a process life cycle is nothing but process of progress from being produced to being completed. That is called as a process life cycle. Then during a process life cycle, the different states that a process passes through reflect the current status of the process in terms of time and often provide information about what is permitted to do next. So a process can create other process which are known as a child process. Process takes more time to terminate and it is isolated, means it does not share memory with any other process. So the process can have the following states like new state, ready state, running state, waiting state, terminated state and suspended state. Process management is concerned with the development of a process, the establishment of a memory space for the process, the loading of the process code into the memory space, then allocation of the system resource, the establishment of a process control block, that is a PCB for the process, and the termination or the deletion of the process. The next slide shows the threads. Thread is a segment of a process, means a process can have multiple threads, and these multiple threads are contained within a process. A thread has three states, running state, ready state and a blocked state. Thread takes less time to terminate as compared to the process, and like process thread do not isolate. Threads maintain their own thread status, program counter and strand. The memory model for a process and its associated threads are shown here. The main difference between a process and threads are, so process means any program is in the execution, whereas a thread means a segment of a process. So process takes more time to terminate, whereas a thread takes less time to terminate. Then process takes more time for creation, whereas a thread takes less time for creation. Then it also takes more time for context switching. It takes less time for context switching. Then process is less efficient in terms of communication. Thread is more efficient in terms of communication. Then process consume more resources, thread consume less resources. Process is isolated, thread share memory. Then process is called a heavy weight process, whereas a thread is called a lightweight process. Then process switching uses a interface in operating system. Thread switching does not require to call an operating system and cause an interrupt to the kernel. If one process is blocked, then it will not affect the execution of other process. Whereas a thread, that is a second thread is a same task could not run while the first one thread is blocked. Then the execution of the other process has its own process control block. Thread has a parent PCB, its own thread control block and a stack and common address space. But in case of a process, it has a own process control block, stack and address space. So these are the difference between process and thread. The next one, the next topic, concept of multitasking. Okay. So the task or process is in an embedded application may be complex or lengthy, and it may be include several sub operations such as receiving input from IO devices connected to the processor, executing internal calculations or operations, then upgrading other IO devices and so on. If all the task sub functions are performed in order, the CPU utilization can be inefficient. So this thread process diagram helps to visualize the process multi-thread architecture. So if the process is divided into several threads, each of which execute a portion of the process, there will be a main thread and the remaining thread will be generated within it. The use of several threads to perform a procedure has the following benefits. The first one, incremental memory usage. So the address space for the data memory is shared by several threads of the same operation. Variables can exchange through threads, which decreases the difficulty of inter-thread communication. Then after that, the CPU can be used by other threads of the process that do not need the event, because the process is split into separate threads. When one thread enters a wait state, which is being processed by the other line, so this shortens the time it takes to complete the procedure. The third one, that is efficient use of a CPU. So thread standard or the various standards for the design and the management of the threads. The operating system uses these specifications for thread development and thread management. So it consists of a set of thread class libraries. The following are the some of the most widely used thread class libraries: POSIX thread, Win32 threads, Java threads. Thread preemption. Preemption or already operating thread is known as thread preemption. The ability of a preemption thread is entirely dependent on the operating system. Thread preemption is used to distribute CPU time evenly among all threads. Thread context switching refers to the switching of the execution between threads. Thread context switching is determined by the operating system scheduler and the type of the thread. So the thread is classified as one of the following. First one, user level thread. Second one, kernel level or system level thread. Third one, many to one model. Fourth one, one to one model. And fifth one, many to many model. So far we have discussed the operating system introduction, kernel details, real-time operating system, real-time kernel functions, hardware and software real-time, task, process and threads. The remaining topics will be covered in the next video. Thank you.